Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and I was working on a report. I wanted to show how many videos Adam, Martha, and myself had done and choose some slicers and things like that. And I want to see how many videos we've done for a given year and then how many videos we've done regardless of the year. And so when I started filtering and slicing, the numbers weren't matching. I was like, something's not right here. And that led me to a property I found called value filter property. And this helped me solve my problem. I actually have two ways to solve this problem. I'm gonna show you in this video. So enough of all this talking, you know what I like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. So I was on my report, and if I choose Adam, for example, Adam's done 25 videos in the past 2 years. If I choose 2024, you'll see how this goes down to 19, but this stays at 25. That's because these are two different measures. The first measure is just doing account rows and videos. That's my dimension. I did do a quick coalesce so I can return zero. Alberto and Marco have videos about how you assign zero. This is just quick and dirty. And then this particular one ignores the year slicer. And so that's why it's maintaining. So if I switch, you see it stays on 25. If I unselect Adam and I choose me, you see I've done 56 videos, and you could see the first card changes, but this one doesn't, right? And this is the exact behavior that I want. And then I went to Martha, and I was like, all right, great. Martha's done six. Actually, she's done like 11 or 12 videos. This is something I got to go fix. Sorry, Martha. Sorry, I'll get this fixed. But in my data right now, she's done six videos. So I chose 2025, say six, because Martha only joined the team in March of this year. But then I chose 2024, and I was stuck. What is going on? How do I fix this? So I started looking at my DAX, and I'm like, no, the DAX is right. And I probably could have done some tricks in the DAX to make this work, but I did something that's causing this problem. Let me show you. If we go over to the model view, I created a single table. I know I say don't do that all the time, but I was just doing some quick analysis of the data. Forgive me. And because I have a single table, my filters, I'm choosing multiple columns. I'm using the year and the host from the same table. And this is actually what's causing the problem. And so I stumbled across this property called value filter behavior. And I just was playing with it, switching it, and it actually fixed the problem. But I needed to know why this was happening. So I went to the internet and I found a document that said, hey, work with the value filter behavior. And I read it. I read it up and down. And to be honest, everybody should go read this if you're working with Power BI, because there can be some implications in your DAX if you don't understand this. And so basically, there's a behavior called auto exist that's part of the semantic model. And what it means is when you have multiple columns from the same table, this guy, DAX understands that likely not all combinations of those values across those columns are valid. And as a result, it automatically excludes those invalid columns. What's happening is in 2025, Martha did six videos and they show up. That's a valid combination. In 2024, Martha didn't do any videos. That combination between Martha and 2024, bam, doesn't work. So it shows zero. The auto exist kicked in. It's actually called coalesce. If I go back to the report and I choose 2024 and Martha, you can see that it says zero. If I go over here in the model view, you can see I have some choices. If I choose independent and I go back here, now it works. So what does that mean, Patrick? Well, let's head back to this doc. So by default, the coalesce auto exist behavior is on. So these two are synonymous with each other. And this is the one that forces the value filter behavior to be enabled. And so if there's an invalid combination, it throws it out in the case of 2024 and Martha. But in the independent one, which I set it to, it forces filters on the same tables to be kept separate. It's an or instead of an and. And so it's ignoring all the filters and still bring me Martha. And so now just by setting that property, my measure works and I don't have to do anything. If you have columns like I have on the exact same table and you're applying filters like I am on both of those columns in the same table, you could encounter this behavior and you need to go set that property to independent. If you don't care, if this is not the behavior you're going for, then you can set it back. One more thing I want to point out in the doc, you'll see that in the near future, and Microsoft will announce this, the default will be independent. Now, I did figure out another way to solve this. And you all may be thinking, well, of course, Patrick, you're filtering by date and you're filtering by host. shouldn't date being a calendar table and then your host being some other dimension table. You're absolutely correct. And I made a star schema. I already have this built out, but you can see I have a dimension table for videos, a dimension table for my calendar table. Then I have my fact table, and then I created the exact same measures. They're slightly different because the data is coming from different tables, but I'm still using my all and I'm still doing a count, but I have to do a count distinct because I have lots and lots of surrogate keys here. Now you can see that I have 141 and 141, just like the other one. If we go over to the model view, you can see it's set to automatic, which right now it defaults to coalesce. And if I choose Martha, it's 6. If I choose 2024, still 6. 2025, still 6. If I add Adam, it'll go up incrementally. If I take Martha away, it still works. So as long as those two columns aren't on the same table, you don't have to worry about that value filter behavior. But if you're like me doing some quick analysis, or maybe your data won't grow and you have a single flat table and everything's in a single column and you want it to work, you need to consider that property at least until Microsoft decides they're going to make the default independent. All right. What do you think? You any questions? You any comments about this? Or are you using this? Have you been aware of this? Unlike Adam and I, right? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric or Power BI, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Martha, Adam, this guy, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.